elements of thunder, water, and wind. Suijin Sangha, Kazajin begin. Meld your powers in eternal light. Show these fools your unstoppable might.
He is pain beyond description.
He'll mark the graves with your inscription.
Gate Guardian!
Welcome back to the segment where we challenge Calvin to take an obscure Yu-Gi-Oh card and create a deck around it. Last time, he managed to summon Thanen the Great Sphinx. This time, he's been tasked with summoning the infamous Gate Guardian, a monster that requires him to summon and tribute three separate pieces from the field. If Calvin fails the challenge, he'll have to wear the loser shirt to every Yu-Gi-Oh tournament until the next episode. This one's a tall order to fill, but let's see if Calvin can.
All right, Duelist, I've got your next challenge for you today. This one is an anime exclusive, by the way. I don't know how much anime you...
Anime exclusive? It wasn't painted?
Well, anime favorite. This is your card.
This is a very old card.
This is a very old card.
Gate Guardian. This card cannot be normal summoned or set.
Always a good start.
This card can only be special summoned by tributing Sangha of the Thunder, Kazajin, and Suijin you control.
Guess what I've got?
Sangha of the Thunder, a Kazajin, and a Suijin. Some big monsters that take two tributes to summon.
Yes. And once you have all of them out,
I can special summon Gate Guardian.
Yeah, by tributing them.
That don't sound fun at all.
Yeah, well.
These cards suck. so really? Gate Guardian can't be normal summon. That's it. That's whatever. I gotta get all of them to the field, special summoning. All three of these monsters had the same effect. You would think the effect would actually help in summoning them or summoning Gate Guardian. Nah, Yu-Gi-Oh! Is not that friendly of a game. All these cards say you can only activate this card's effect during your opponent's damage calculation. Make the attack of a monster attacking this card zero during damage calculation. This effect can only be used once as long as this card remains face up on the field. At all level 7, so they require two tributes. The effects don't help to summoning this big Gate Guardian guy. What do I have to do first, Bob?
You have to summon Gate Guardian and win the game in five turns. So five turns to
summon this big brawler dude in five turns and win the game.
Right.
Okay. My first thought is probably like some kind of like tribute summon monarch kind of thing.
How are you gonna actually guarantee that you get to them? Cause like, I mean, they can't be, can they be searched?
I walk by faith, not by sight. Nah, I don't know them. They search them off top.
Yeah,
top
I mean, wait, well, okay. What types of attributes do we have?
Thunder, light, aqua, water. Why is the spellcaster win? Spellcaster win. Or just hope for the best and let the heart of the paradox guide me or something.
All right, so I guess we get started with monarchs then?
Yeah, monarchs. And I think Alec has monarchs.
All right, these are my babies. Take care of them.
They were those are your babies, but you had them in the car. Okay.
These are my monarchs.
Well, I've got monarchs now from Alec that kept them in his car for some odd reason. I know Stormforth, that's the one that lets me tribute on my opponent's turn, so.
It's a quick play, so you can use them whenever you want.
But is there anything else that helps me with tribute summoning?
I mean, you're supposed to kind of just handle that yourself. The vassals can summon themselves to be tribute fodder.
Hold on. This is kind of helpful. So it's just like, just basically just free tribute fodder.
Yep.
Yeah.
I don't know what else you got planning, but those monsters look pretty big, and the vassals are kind of made for that.
You said I got five turns, right? I'm gonna need some double summons. Cause like, even if I summon one per turn, I still have to get the Gate Guardian. And then, that mean it'll possibly take me four turns to even just get the monsters to the field.
Gotta binder of commons right here, so.
Yep. I'm glad you have binders out this time. So yeah, hopefully, well, I'm looking for double summon, but even though I'm looking for that, it might be some other things that maybe somewhere useful. Okay, spells. What card am I looking for again?
Double summon.
Double summon. Yeah, okay, yeah. I knew it was something like that. None of...
Instant fusion might be...
Level ones? Yo, those are level ones. Wait, can the monster summon by instant fusion be attributed?
Maybe.
Pay 1,000 life points for something. Only 5 months, but cannot test. Good eye, Paul. Good eye. Took this one for one too, just in case. Might need that. Monster Reborn?
Maybe. I mean, probably, right?
Just because I need an extra. Well, I guess.
I mean, also, one of them might die.
Can these be brought back? Yeah, these can be brought back. But like, we're making Oh! And Double Summon is not at one either. I think I need all three of these.
Hey guys, so, you know, I'm Alec, the antagonist. And Paul always gives me a different deck to use to try and stop Calvin from completing his challenges. Well, I asked for the Link Strike Structure deck, and he got close. He got me the Cybers Link Structure deck, which is better because it's the newer version of that structure. And so I guess that's a good thing. It had the Tri-Guy Wizard, I forget his name, Tri-Gate Wizard, Binary Sorceress, and Encode Talker. It has cards like Different Dimension Reincarnation, Cosmic Cyclone. So this is just an all-around better deck to use. And I'm going to use my linking skills to defeat Calvin here and put an end to Calvin Can.
So yeah, basically at this point, I have like a 20 card backbone, I guess, of Monarchs and, again, Gate Guardian pieces. Dark World Dealings, Into the Void. I'll even take Upstart Goblin at this point. I just need a way to make sure I can get the pieces to my hand, I guess, so I can start summoning stuff. So I see something right here that I think will make the deck a little bit more spicy. Right.
What you got?
Got a Pillman Call. This is my planning right now. I'm gonna run like one of all the good draw cards since I only play on once anyway. And then use the Pendulum mechanics also. Cause that way, even if I don't normal summon them, I can still special summon them from my hand and then just tribute summon. Since I have to actually win in five turns, I can put some monsters on the board and just not just get like completely demolished their turn.
They can be pendulum summoned. So you need to have, what level are they?
All these are level 7. So I just need stuff that's like between what, 1 and 8?
Basically an 8 scale.
Yeah.
And anything else.
And then like I said, Pendulum Call gets cards out of my deck. Gets 2 cards out of my deck actually. So that helps with the extra draw power.
This can search, I mean there's like the Magician cards, so this could work.
Yeah, that's what I'm probably gonna end up getting, the Magicians.
I don't know how many good magicians we have.
I don't worry about them being good. I just need them to be like
playable.
Stuff I can draw. Yeah, stuff like I can put in my scales.
Shout out to Ridge Wallet for sponsoring today's video. Ridge has redefined the wallet with its slim size, sleek design, and variety of colors. It makes the perfect Father's Day gift, so pick one up today at the link in the video description.
I think this is what I came up with out of my 40 card deck. Is Pendulum. Draw power, Monarch, Guardian deck. Y'all can make up your own acronym, whatever y'all want to call it. These are ones I think are the better three out of what I found. Dragon Pit, Dragon Collar, and Zonky. Mostly because all these are level 7s. And these two are dark, so Allure helps. But mostly because these are all the level 7s. This was kind of an add-in that I saw in the box. Only because it's like also a level 7 and it's dark. And because I needed like synergy with the popper up. So I think it's going to work. I don't know. And normally I would go online, test it out to see if it works or not. I want to actually go in blind knowing nothing. Like I just want to like play and see if my idea works. I don't want to try it online first. See what doesn't work and then change. I'm just gonna go in, trust my gut feeling. So I'm just gonna skip
God,
that.
Oh God, okay, good yeah. Luck.
Hi, my head. I got a 2. See, that's a bad start already.
Oh, you're going down.
That's
boy.
A bad start.
3.
Okay, you choose yeah. Who first.
Then. I'm going first.
Hi. We already shuffled. Oh, this is gonna be bad.
Come on, here we go. Here we go. Let's go. Today is the day I end Calvin Can. We're going to have to rename it Calvin Can't. All right. Start off with a terrible hand. I'm going to set one and then set another and I'll pass.
Okay. I can deal with that then. Okay. Draw for turn. Activate Dark World Dealings. Each player draws one card and each player discards one card.
All right.
I would discard Metaphor's Fusion. I don't even want to attack. Play Sacred Sword of Seven Stars. Banish one level 7 monster from my hand or face up from my side of the field. Draw 2 cards. I'll banish the Zonki Magician.
Alright.
And draw 2. I will activate the effect of Metaphor's Fusion.
Yes.
So let me shuffle it back into my deck and then draw a card. Well, I'm drawing, I just don't know what I'm getting into.
You gotta get there.
I'm doing something. Things are happening slowly. Come on, give me a good cut. Give me some stuff I need. Norma Summon Eidos, the Underworld Squire. Since it's a spellcaster, I will activate Spellbook of Knowledge. Since it's a graveyard, either one spellcaster monster you control or one of the spellbook card from your hand or field, sell Spellbook of Knowledge. If you do, I can draw 2 cards.
Yes.
And this is a spellcaster. I will set 1 card. And I will end my turn.
Alright, so not that different from me.
Yeah, it wasn't too bad. I drew. It, you know.
Drop a turn.
Thought I went on a little bit better. Attacking me for game. Here it comes.
I'll normal summon my Balancer Lord.
Yes.
I can pay 1,000 life points to get an additional normal summon of a Cyberus monster, but I will not be doing that.
Okay.
I will instead be playing my Cynet Backdoor, where I target a Cyberus monster I control, I banish it, and if I do, I get to add 1 Cyberus monster from deck to hand whose attack is lower than it. So it has 1,700.
So I'm 17.
Yes. I add Cly Ant to my hand. Also, my monster, it will return to the field on my next standby phase, and that turn it's able to attack directly.
Okay.
I will flip some of my Magician of Faith so I can add my Cynet Backdoor to hand.
That legal?
Yeah.
It came in the deck. Or did you put that in there?
It came in the deck.
I think you cheat. Nah,
it came in the deck.
I think you cheat, but all right.
I'll activate my DDR, Different Dimensional Reincarnation.
Oh, he definitely cheating. Yeah.
So I discard a card, and then I can target one of my banished monsters and add it to my hand.
Nah, he's going to special summon it.
Special summon, my bad. Misspoke. I'll special summon my Balancer Lord.
Mm-hmm.
It stays. And now I'll actually use my Balancer Lord's effect. I will pay 1,000 life points.
Pay 1,000.
And now I get an additional normal summon of a Cyberus monster this turn. I'll normal summon my Cly Ant. And when it is normal summoned, the card is face up on the field. All my Cyberus monsters gain 500 attack and defense during my turn only. I believe, and if it would be destroyed by battle or card effect, I can destroy a Cyberus monster in my hand instead.
Okay.
So I'll go ahead and enter battle.
Yes.
My Balancer Lord is 23. He'll attack you directly. 22.
Yeah, plus 5. Yeah, I'm taking it.
Mission of Faith is just 300, so he'll attack for 300. Yeah. And then Client will attack for, I guess it includes himself, so 2,000. And next, I move to main phase 2.
Mm-hmm. Makes access code. Yeah,
something burns.
Wouldn't that be crazy? Let's see. Let's go Link 3. Link 3 into my Encode Talker.
What does what? I've never seen it.
So he'll only do something when he points to one of my other monsters. I believe, yeah, so before the MSP calculation, if a monster I control battles one of your monsters, that my monster, I can make my monster not destroyed by that battle, and I take no battle damage. Also, I can make one of the monsters he points to gain attack equal to the monster that battled it.
Okay.
But that's not a big deal here. I'll set 1 card
face
down.
That's a big deal.
And I'll pass.
Oh, boy.
It's all up to the draw.
And draw for turn.
This is the second turn.
Activate Pendulum Call.
Pendulum Call.
Discard a card and I add 2 Magician Pendulum monsters with different names. They can't be destroyed until after this card is out. Pendulum monsters can be destroyed by card effects. Okay, so 2 Pendulum monsters, Magicians with different names. So 1, 2. Those who I want, hold on. I'm being bad here. We'll keep him, man. We'll get something else. Get that. Activate Sacred Sword of 7 Stars.
Yes.
I will banish a level 7 from my hand, switching, and draw 2. 1, 2. I place Dragon Pit Magician in 1 scale. He's a 8. And plays Zonki Magician in the other one. And I will attempt to Pendulum Summon. 1 Sangha of Thunder and a Dragon Collar in defense.
Oh, the first piece is here. Woo!
First piece here, but still I need more. I will now attempt.
What does Sangha do?
Sangha, you can only activate this card effect during your opponent's damage calculation.
Okay.
Make the attack of a monster attacking this card 0 during damage calculation. This effect can only be used once as long as this card remains face up on the field.
Okay. All right. I got your business.
So I will attempt to enter battle phase.
You can attempt it.
attack with Song of a Thunder.
I'll activate my Cynet Bag Door. So like I said before, I can banish my monster. Uh-huh. And then I can add to my hand a Cybers monster with less attack than it, and it will come back on my next standby phase.
Okay.
I'll add my Launcher Commander to hand. He is a 1700 Cybers.
Since the monsters on the field change,
yes,
I will attempt to attack for 26.
2600.
Move towards main phase 2. Move towards end phase.
All right. Drop.
Yes.
Standby.
Yes.
My sign it back door will let me get my Encode Talker back. Oh, I can really put him in any spot I want, but I guess he's best here.
He actually can't go back.
He can't go back.
He has to go to the main monster zone.
Oh, never mind then. I missed. No, don't listen to me.
He like has to go to a main monster zone.
Oh, he has to go to the main monster zone. I will normal summon my Launcher Commander.
Mm-hmm. Do what you do.
So all other Cybers monsters will gain 300 attack and defense.
Oh, other him too.
All other.
Okay, so.
So Encode Talker is 2600.
Yes.
And I will enter battle, mm-hmm. and Encode Talker will attack you directly.
Oh, he does that?
Because Cynet Backdoor gives that
ability. Oh, yeah, to the monster. That's right. Yeah, I'm taking that 26 then. This is looking real grim, Paul.
And it's not the best scenario.
Now, Launcher Commander will attack your Dragon Caller. Yeah, that's the name.
All right, I'll just put him on.
You got one now?
Didn't think about that part.
All right, and main phase 2.
Yes.
I'll use my Launcher Commander's effect. I can tribute one Cybers monster, then target a face of monster you control and destroy it. So I'll tribute my Launcher, destroy your Sangha.
Yes.
And then I'll set one card face down.
I'm tired of you setting cards.
And I'll pass.
So he's back at 23.
Yes.
Okay. Draw.
It's turn 3.
Woo. I don't know what your back row is. That's scary. I will use the effect of my Dragon Pit Magician. Once per turn, if you have a Magician card in your other Pendulum Zone, you can discard one Pendulum Monster, then target one Spell Trap card on the field and destroy it. I discard a Pendulum, and I'll target that to destroy it.
You hit the dead one.
Don't say, oh,
that was my recoded alive.
I will attempt to pendulum something.
Go for it.
I will move towards battle phase.
Battle phase.
I don't like your green. If that deck has a magic stone, then I'm going to be...
You know, all these structure decks
I'm
have
be
like
mad.
A mirror horse or something.
I'm going to be mad. Dragon Collar will attempt to attack your Encode Talker.
Alright, okay.
Dragon Collar dies. I'll take 100.
You'll take 100. Okay, cool. Okay. I will now move towards main phase 2 and then move towards end phase.
Alright then.
That was turn 3, Paul.
That was turn 3.
Draw. And no choice. I'll normal summon my card trooper.
Yes.
And I'll activate its effect to mail the top 3 cards of my deck.
Yeah. Don't you gain like 500 take?
500 for each card.
Okay.
1, 2.
I feel like something's gonna have a graveyard effect.
None of them.
None of them have a graveyard effect?
They do not.
Okay.
Unless he does. I'll pass there.
Where are my draw cards? I'm reading some. Draw for turn.
Turn 4. First 4.
Move towards battle phase. Dragon Collar attack card trooper.
I'll take that. That's 2000 damage. Then a card trooper effect.
Yeah, draw your card. I don't like that draw. Move towards end phase.
Okay. Drop a turn.
Don't be going in there. Nah, stop it. Don't do that.
I will normal summon my mathematician.
Mm-hmm.
When it's normal summon, I can send a level 4 or lower monster from deck to grave.
Yeah.
I'll send my glow up bulb.
That's a card.
You ain't telling me how to hit a glow up bulb enough. You got all the good band cards. I got a gate guardian.
I mean, you know how it is.
No, I don't.
You know how it is. Effective glow up bulb.
Yeah, if you build a dotscape.
Mail the top.
That'd be really funny.
But if you would have built a dotscape, I would have just quit.
That hurt.
Just right there, just quit.
Glow up bulb. I really wanted to mail a dotscape.
I would have quit.
I have no choice but to pass there.
All right, it's the final turn.
So are you summoning Gate Guardian here?
We're gonna see. A lot of cards left in my deck. Draw for turn.
Ooh, oh, I see. Yeah. That's a risk.
I have to gamble.
Well, it's turn 5. End of this turn.
You lose.
You'll lose or you'll win.
A Lyra Darkness.
Let's go.
Only one look, Paul. No!
draw your second pathetic card.
Yeah, okay, draw the second. It could, hey, it could change something.
No, it won't.
It could. It could. There's a chance.
But that's not what I need, though. I will banish when the gamble some more. I will set one card. I will use the Faith of Dragon Magician.
Yes.
Discard on Magician to pop my card. Activate the Faith of Metal Foes Fusion.
Oh man, this is really.
Woo!
This is crazy.
I'm surviving.
So now it's all down to this one little draw.
Oh my god. I don't like this draw at all, bro.
I like the fact I get to cut it.
I don't like this draw at all.
Metal Foes Fusion.
Yo, check this out. Check this out. Hey, you don't get that. You know what? Here it go.
You play with my emotions, Smokey.
Alright, it all comes out of this.
That card was a gift.
It's better not be another Lure of Darkness.
It's another gamble.
I don't even want to draw the card. I will Pendulum Summon.
That doesn't look right.
Yeah, some kind of off about the Pendulum Summon. One of these is the wrong monster. One of these is not quite the right monster. I will move towards battle phase. I'm at least attack with one of them. Song of the Thunder, attack, mathematician.
That's 15 to 26.
Zonky Magician will attack the glow up bulb.
A mathematician has an effect too.
You draw a card.
I get to draw one card.
Zonky Magician will attack the glow up bulb. I will attack for a fake game with Suijin.
Fake game with Suijin. And I guess that's it.
I will end my turn and reveal my hand.
Your poor soul.
If the one card you took from the top and put on the bottom of my deck is Kazujin, we fighting right now.
We gotta check.
If this, I'm gonna show y'all at the same time. If this card at the bottom of my deck is Kazujin, we're really fighting. Okay.
See,
what was the Kazujin?
It was much deeper than you got.
Oh, I was not close.
You weren't close. It was the second last card. It was the second last card.
Oh, no.
Oh, no.
Am I not? Oh, wow.
Yeah, he was somewhere.
He was down there.
All right, guys. So Calvin wins the duel.
And loses the challenge.
Yes, so.
I guess Calvin can't.
You know I really don't like you, right? You don't understand. When I realized Dragon Pit could pop my own card and I saw that Metaphor Fusion, I'm like, bro.
I have to
gamble again.
If that had gotten you Kazujin, that was it. This we're never doing this segment again. You're too lucky.
Honestly, I hate that card with a passion. With a passion, I do not like that card. I think those were probably the best cards in the... I think that was like the best draw power. I don't know. I should have took that out from like another spell book or something, or any kind of other draw power than that, because that card is too much of a gamble.
Yeah.
Way too much. If you want more of these, make sure you like, comment, subscribe. Let me know what cards you want to see me win with. You know, what cards you want me to try to make a deck around. This will not happen again. This card was hard because it revolves three other monsters.
That is true. It's... Would you say
but I liked it though.
Would you say this is the hardest one yet?
Or yes, because like, it resolved the other three monsters. Yes, this is the hardest.
I think Dark Sage seemed harder, but...
But that's searchable stuff. Dark Magician has so much support.
Dark Sage was like 100%.
I would hazard to say I had the more difficult deck, because I had to summon these three monsters, and any of them by themselves do nothing.
That's true.
That is also true.
This was difficult to work with.
I'll give you that. We're like slight friends.